Hello, as we can see, we have multiple workbooks in our Open Excel application. We want a macro which is a follow-up to earlier videos, however we want to affect the insertion of rows into all worksheets across all open workbooks. Go to Visual Basic for Applications and insert a module. Whenever writing a customized macro in Excel, it's advisable to notate your macro so that future users of your macro will understand its purpose. Let's call this macro Insert Row Sheets Workbooks. Remember to disable the following Excel properties as it will improve the macro's performance and efficiency. Next, we want to declare our object variables for the macro. Now we need to state the active row from where we want to insert the rows. To improve the macro stability, we shall state the active workbook and worksheets. This way, the cursor will return to the initial workbook and worksheet upon completion of the macro. The iCountRows variable will quantify the number of rows to insert across the worksheets and workbooks. Make sure to write this piece of code accurately, otherwise the macro may not execute properly. It is always wise to feature some error handling code in a macro because it will prevent runtime errors from the erroneous use of the macro by users. Clearly, we want the macro to stop if a user inputs a zero, negative value, or non-numerical value into the input box. The loop feature of the code is critical as it will enable the macro to move from open workbook to open workbook. Then we require a second loop to loop through the worksheets for each respective workbook. This piece of code is crucial. Any typo or misspelling will likely prevent the macro from working properly. Once the macro has looped through all worksheets in the active workbook and inserted the specified number of rows in each worksheet, we want to move the cursor back to cell A1 in sheet 1 or the far left-hand worksheet. We now want to move to the next workbook. Next, we want to move the cursor back to the initial workbook and worksheet, where we made the initial row insertion. The macro is complete. We can now re-enable the following Excel properties. Let's review the macro one final time. We are now ready to insert rows across all worksheets and all open workbooks. As we can see, the macro is working precisely. Feel free to subscribe to our channel, like this video, or send us a comment.